Welcome to video number two. I'm so glad that you're here and I'm excited to be sharing with you. If you didn't watch the whole of the first video, let me give you a quick summary, but honestly, you should go back and watch it. In the first video, I shared with you, you know, the five different geniuses that an entrepreneur has. I talked about the seeker, the starter, the promoter, the builder, and the operator. And hopefully you started to get an idea of, you know, which type you are. You know, as an entrepreneur that wants to build a big business, you have to understand that you need to own your genius and surround yourself with other people. So which one are you? You know, are you the person that has ideas? Are you the seeker? Do you have all these different ideas? Or are you the person that actually can get things started but don't finish? Or are you the promoter? You're able to promote everyone else's stuff and you're able to get people moving to you, but maybe you struggle with sales or you don't really have product ideas. Or are you the builder? You build things, you love to create products, or do you love to operate a team? Which one are you? See, most entrepreneurs, this is the journey that they go through. They master a skill first. So there's some sort of skill that they have, or maybe they have a product that they've created. Then they need to go out there and sell that thing. Some people never get past this. They're a builder. They're too busy just building and building and building, so they never go out and sell. However, some of us, starters like me, we get out there and we can get things started. But then the next place is now once we've sold it to everybody we know or, you know, everyone we can find, we don't know how to promote. So promotion comes in next. And we call this the fast track. I named my business after this. After helping thousands of entrepreneurs around the world to build their business and creating multiple million-dollar businesses myself, I realized that there was this path. So the next thing is the promoter comes in. Now, typically, the promoter comes in and promotes somebody else who's already started something and already come up with the idea. And so the promoter comes in here and starts to help the next person is the builder. So once the promoter has come in and actually got a whole of people racing towards this brand, this product, the builder comes in and creates the process. Then once the processes are there, the operator comes in. Now, the operator leads the team and actually grows the business. So typically, in order to get to a million, you need to master the seeker, the starter, and the promoter. Once you're going to start hitting close to that million-dollar range, now it depends what industry you're in. It actually depends where your business is located. But, you know, between about 600, 700,000 and a million, the builder and processes and systems become super important, but not before then. Then once you start to move through that, the operator comes in. So some business owners try to go through this in a linear fashion. They think they need to be every type of person. So what happens is they try to go through it themselves. It's one of the biggest mistakes that I see. I see an entrepreneur going, okay, great, I've got a good idea, or I need to go figure out how to have an idea if they're one of the other personality types, or now I've got to go learn how to sell, or now I've got to go learn how to be a marketer, or now I need to learn how to build processes, or now I need to learn how to run a team. The truth is, as a business owner, you want to employ one person in each of those areas. You need to have in your organization somebody who's great at coming up with ideas, somebody who's great at getting people to buy things, a starter, somebody who's great at promotion, somebody who's great at systems and technology and processes, and then somebody running the show. And you are the one that holds everyone together. That's the position of the entrepreneur, a little bit of all of them. However, we get stuck trying to learn every piece and do it all ourselves. So building companies and helping people to build companies, what I found is my specialty and my team, we're brilliant at doing one thing. If someone has an idea and they know how to sell it, we know how to make that thing big. We did it again and again and again and again for so many people. I mean, I'm in a movie with Tony Robbins and the Dalai Lama. Even they came to us. Gary Vaynerchuk's team, they came to us. You know, he can pretty much ask anyone to do marketing, but we did it for him. So I found my area of genius, because what I found is there's just four things. If you want to build a significantly big business, there's four things you must have. The first thing you must have is monetized value. Write that down. What that means is if you're a seeker, you need to choose something that is valuable to other people that people will actually buy. And this takes you into the starter place. So that's the first goal. You must have monetized value, which is something that's valuable that people buy. What is value? Value is simple. You either give more pleasure to somebody or take away a pain. That's it. Value has an easy definition. It's something that the market wants because it creates pleasure or it reduces a pain. So that's value, then monetize it. The second thing that you've got to have is you must have a distribution system. So now this is where you get into the promoter and the builder. you must be able to distribute that product. So now you've got monetized value. Now you must distribute the product. You must know how to actually get it out. Are you gonna go retail? Are you gonna go online, which is my favorite? I love building out e-commerce sites. I love building out ecosystems. I'm sick and tired of hearing this word funnel everywhere. It's just one small part of a whole ecosystem. You need an ecosystem that creates distribution of your product. The next thing is you need to be able to create leveraged delivery. If you're an entrepreneur, you are going to get stuck in business if you don't know how to actually deliver your product or service with leverage. There's only two ways to do this, and this is the cross between the builder and the operator, because to have leverage delivery, it's either technology or team. Those are the only two things that are going to create leverage. How do you deliver the product without it being actually wrapped around you? And then the last thing that you need is you need a fully optimized team. You need staff that can come in and fill all the gaps, that can do all the operations, the customer support, build everything that you need. That's the last thing you need. Now, in the next video, I want to talk to you about how you actually go about making this happen, because these four things are super important, but we want to make sure that you, the entrepreneur, number one, has monetized value. So we're going to figure that out. Number two, I want to show you how you actually create your distribution system. Number three, how are you going to create leverage delivery? And number four, how do you have an optimized team? So if you love this video, comment below. I really care about you. My job is to create as much value for you as possible. I'm so glad that we're starting off this relationship the right way. Let me know if you love this video. Let me know which place you're in and if this helped. I'll see you in the next video when we actually go about how do we put this in place and how some of my clients have been able to create some massive success. I hope you're enjoying it. I'll see you in the next video.